Hello, ladies and gentlemen of the internet and of YouTube. Welcome back to Final Fantasy Chronicles of Ino. Just as a quick notification, I have a new microphone and I'm still kind of fiddling with the sound settings on it. So if I sound weird this session, that's because I'm still adjusting levels to make myself sound right. But yeah, anyway, so today we have with us our full cast of players. We have Hades Shadow 92 playing Thanatos, our male human Dark Knight.
My head is pounding. Wait, where's my scythe?
We have the ever-lovely Luminous Starlight playing Rocket, the female cyborg chocobo warrior.
I'm eating chocolate.
Nice. We have Darkness playing Alistair, our male human paladin.
Back again.
And we have Tom117Z playing Neathil, the female Elvon ranger and the star of our current plot arc.
There is no Neathil, there's only Emma.
At least for this session.
Yeah. Well,
a lot of it anyway.
So, as you will all... So, to recap where we left off last, our intrepid band of adventurers spent the vast majority, pretty much all of the session, just in the city of Vitae, going through a series of events largely revolving around Nee trying to get things sorted out between introducing her parents to Panara and getting everyone up to speed on the situation with Emma and Aralia and herself and Panara's involvement and the soul transplanting shit that is really complicated and long-winded to explain. Following that, Neathil's father, adoptive father, Farron, took her to acquire a ring with which she will at some point in the future propose to Mika. Following that, they then went to the castle with Panara in tow to confront Gubranth, who is currently situated in the castle dungeons. There was a emotional discussion at the close of which everyone just sort of left Gubranth there in the cell, feeling a little more resolve, but also very disheartened, I suppose. But at finally, the party then reconvened at a local inn and tavern, the Coiled Arrow, I believe it was? Or the Spiral Arrow? One or the other. But
Spiral Arrow.
Right, the Spiral Arrow. And in the Spiral Arrow, some amazing things had happened. For one thing, Rocket had gotten drunk for the first time in her life, and it was a spectacle to behold, ending with her attempting to do a backflip and just kind of face planting into the ceiling and then face planting into the floor and falling unconscious. Nee and Thanatos then, in an effort to lighten the mood from recent events, had a drinking contest amongst themselves, which ended in Thanatos earning a victory, but Neathil decided to be a rotten sport at the very end and threw her mug in his face just as she was passing out, making him pass out too.
Hey, it was all part of the plan for the tree.
Cheating elf.
It was still cheating. It was still cheating.
Hey, true competition was stealing a sight, and I succeeded, so...
You dastardly knife ears.
Hey, you meet Diabolos and see if he's going to complain about cheating.
Well, following that, everyone went either to the Ithil family estate, or, in the case of Nian, Mika, and Panara, to Ni's personal home in the city of Vite, where everyone got down and got some sleep after some extracurricular activities took place.
Snip, snip,
scissors, they exist. After said extracurricular activities, Ni and Panara entered into Ni's dreams using Panara's known ability to contact her in her sleep, through which they were able to speak with Emma. And after a while of talking to her and hearing how she feels in her side of things, eventually managed to come to an agreement to, for the time being, while they look for a more permanent solution, allowing Emma 48 hours in control of Ni's body, or the body, I suppose, since they sort of share it, to just sort of know what it's like to even have one. With the agreement being that Ni would explain things to the rest of the party first. And so it is on that note, as everyone is waking up, that we enter the game. So, everyone, you come to in the respective establishments. Ni, you wake up in your home. Everyone else, you are in the Ithil family estate. So, what are you all doing?
Well, who are we following first?
Let's start with you, since this is your arc. So, you awaken in bed, and Mika isn't long behind you, sort of coming to with the big old cute yawn.
You're adorable in the morning. Your ears twitch, you know that.
And she just kind of flicks your nose and sits up, holding the blankets up to her chest, because you're both still up.
Where's the birthday suits?
Yes, you're in the all together.
Oh my!
Look, they banged as they were going to bed. They didn't really think to put their clothes back on yet.
Can we just have Panara just walk in there? And...
I think she'd know what he said. Milk. Anyway.
No, she does not enter.
Damn. She broke collapse. You. So where were we?
You were getting up.
Oh yeah, we just got flicked on the nose and he was complaining about it.
Yeah.
That was it.
Yeah. So as you're sort of up waking up, Mika turns to you.
So how did it go?
Ah, right. Well, it went better than last time, considering there were no big explosions.
Right.
There is a slight catch, though.
Uh-oh, I don't like the sound of that.
We'll see. After we've informed the others today, I've sort of promised Emma 2 days in the command seat.
Oh. Starting when?
Once the others have been informed and I give her the go-ahead, essentially.
Are you sure it's going to be fine?
Mother's going to be keeping an eye on things, and if anything goes wrong, I trust that you'll be coming to my rescue.
Of course, anytime.
I'm hoping this gives her a chance to kind of figure things out. You know, not being cooped up inside my head.
Right.
Maybe then something can come out of all this.
Here's to hoping.
Hey, it's 2 days, and I'll be right back with you. Alright?
Alright. I'm trusting you on this.
I'm trusting me on this.
I'm trusting that you know what you're doing.
As much as I can do. This isn't exactly an orthodox situation, I find. I'm sure you've written at least 5 essays about me.
Not written, per se. I mean, I've splurged about you a few times to my mentor, but it's a bit different.
Nice things, I hope?
Mostly, yeah. Pretty much the only negative thing I can think I've ever said about you is stupid sexy knee.
Knee blushes. Blunt, but flattered, I guess.
She just rolls her eyes and sort of nudges you in the side.
Eh, what can I say? It's kind of hard to think when you're working your magic.
Oh, I'll take that as a compliment then.
It took you a second to realize what she meant.
Yeah.
It took you a second. That's canon. It took me a second.
Yeah. Me blushes deeper.
Alright, well. Mika sort of nods, gives you a comforting side hug, and then sort of goes to get dressed.
Good plan. I don't think Mother would appreciate the surprise if we forgot.
Probably not.
Speaking of, we probably should head back to the town as soon as there aren't any food in the house for breakfast. And I also need to give Thanatos back his scythe.
Probably would be a good idea, yeah. He likes that thing. I mean, isn't that the one that Caius just randomly gave him before we fought Chakal? Or is that a different one?
I think so. I mean, he had a couple. He wielded Verminion's Edge for a while.
Yeah, he's still hanging on to that, as I recall, isn't he?
Battle trophy?
Maybe. You can ask him when we get there.
Hello. Right, need
so,
to go to strap on her armor.
Yep, so you get your clothes back on, and soon enough you're heading back down, and you see Panara there, sort of still sitting cross-legged in the middle of the floor with her head down. Sort of slow, even breaths.
You're up.
She...
Have you been there all night?
I have.
She stands up and sort of... stretches a bit. Looks like she's a little stiff.
I've learned how to sleep in unusual positions.
Doesn't look comfortable.
It's more comfortable than you might expect when you're used to it. As a soldier, I thought you would have figured that out by now.
Hey, even if it's on stone or dirt or whatever, at least I'm laying down usually, not meditating. Seems bad for the back.
Well, it does what it needs to do.
She then, her expression sobers somewhat and she focuses on you a bit more intently.
So, when are we planning on handing over the reins?
The moment the others have been informed and details have been sorted out. When it happens... Make sure you get my armor back from her. I don't want dumping in a ditch.
Right. Shall we go then?
You are gonna keep an eye on things, right? When this goes on?
It's my fault things like this are happening, so yes. I mean to do what I have to.
I have no reason to doubt that she won't give it back after 2 days. I mean, I can see in her head. But still, it's a daunting prospect. For differing reasons.
Right. We should probably get a move on then.
Right, it's just another chapter in my dumb life.
It's not right, dumb. It's scythe. Complicated.
Picks up the scythe where she left it.
Yep. You pick up the scythe and
same difference.
You pick up the scythe, and it sort of tingles a bit in your hand.
Tingle?
You're not sure, but you get the impression it is annoyed.
How could a scythe be annoyed?
Well, I mean, Caius created it, so...
She kind of looks at it for a minute, raising an eyebrow. He brought this on himself, Caius.
The vibrating sort of diminishes a little bit as if... fair point.
So, wait, Caius is in the scythe, too?
I mean, he created it. It's an extension of him.
She turns and the other says, well, I just learned that Caius is in this thing as well, so I technically kidnapped Caius. Oh, boy.
Mika just sort of smirks.
That is magnificent.
Panara raises an eyebrow.
That is confusing, but okay.
That's confusing? That's coming from you.
No, because I understand what's going on with you. I have no idea what the hell Thanatos' deal is.
Oh, weird Dark Knight angst and usual.
I'll call you in another time. It's a long story in its own right.
Oh, I'm sure.
Well, in the meantime, let's get him, points at the scythe, back to Thanatos before, you know, he freaks out too much.
All right. And with that, you go ahead and you set out from your home and start making your way back to your family estate. It's a nice morning as you're heading on the way. There aren't very many people out and about. Sort of a gentle breeze that sort of whooshes through the streets, whistling through some of the architectural shapes and constructs on building sides. It's relaxing and sort of settles your nerves about what's to come a little bit. As you're going, the few people you do pass do sort of give Panara these sidelong glances, like they're surprised and a little weary at the sight of her. And it's not hard to imagine why. No one in the city has ever met a Zalaran before, so her appearance is probably off-putting. Pale skin, purple eyes, dark clothing, the works.
Whenever that happens, Nee just kind of gives them a look of Ranger business, mind your own.
Yeah, and they do, but that doesn't stop them from looking. With either confusion or suspicion or weariness or just general curiosity. But eventually, you arrive at your family's home. And you make your way inside, and we'll go ahead and cut to the others at this point. Everyone's waking up. Rocket, as you are coming to, you're muted, by the way. As you are coming to, your screen, or rather your vision, is just a mess of error boxes that you forgot how to close last night. There are like 17 little notifications saying you are poisoned, 13 little errors informing you that you have lost there's been some miscommunication in giving commands to your mechanical leg. Your rocket boosters have failed to reboot at least 17 times while you were unconscious. And just a general assortment of other little errors and pop-ups and notifications warning you about the side effects of being drunk, like contamination detected in your liver and so on.
So is this the equivalent of Rocket having a hangover?
Oh, you also have one hell of a headache. And your and your beak and your throat are really dry, and your stomach feels like a cactar did the songbird serenade in there.
Oh.
So yeah, you're not feeling too hot.
I'm gonna go back to
sleep. So Rocket just goes back to sleep. Just no, he just curls up and just okay. What are the rest of you doing? You're all awake and up and about. What you doing?
Of course,
Thanatos is saying fuck it to the new day. The Mythic Dawn would be proud.
Fucking hey, even with Persona. Is he? Hey, Dark Snoring, wake up. Idiot. Doesn't even realize his cipher's gone. Well, time for the old method to wake him up.
Oh no, what are you doing?
Find some cold ice water.
Oh no!
All right. So you have to find some cold ice water.
All right, as you're scouring the house for ice water, we'll say it's at about that time as you're going downstairs that Nii, Mika, and Panara enter, and the rest of the family are already up and about.
So, Alistair, what are you doing?
Waking up Thanatos, without the stick for once, as he calls it.
Oh, so he's not even awake yet?
Nope, but this will wake him up.
You haven't found ice water yet.
She glances at the side. In that case, I'll wait at the kitchen, and I'll listen up for his reaction. Tell me when he's awake.
Oh, you hear it, all right.
All right. Well, so you keep looking around, and eventually you find a bucket and manage to get it filled up with cold water from the well out back.
Mm-hmm.
And, you make your way back upstairs, a big bucket of cold water in hand, march into Thanatos' room where he's still snoring soundly away.
Wakey, wakey, sunshine.
Spoosh!
And well, no, here's what happens. He jolts up so quickly, hand reached out, he accidentally throws a fireball.
Ouch.
You're casting fire?
But I need to roll to dodge.
Can we just say like a small, like maybe like a little bigger than a wisp kind of fireball?
Okay, so you're casting Conjure Wisp and just yunking it at Alistair. Hang on, I need to double check the damage output on Conjure Wisp.
I'm pretty sure it doesn't do any damage.
It does do damage if it hits a living creature. Give me a
Which
second.
Which is why I'm attempting to dodge.
I think it's just a 1d6, though.
So. Yeah, chances are the magic armor absorbs all of it.
Conjure Wisps. Wisps may be used to attack a target and will inflict magic armor damage equal to the caster's mind attribute before winking out if successful.
My mind is 6.
So 6 damage, so minus Alistair's magic armor. Yeah, so Alistair just...
Denied.
Yeah, so you sploosh down as he wakes up. Phew, a little fireball comes out of his hand and just splats harmlessly against your chest like a useless little Furby.
Seeing himself wet and Alistair standing in front of him with a bucket. Alistair.
Yes?
Tell me. How upset would your family be if I sent you back in a box?
Oh, deeply, and it ain't gonna happen. Unless you don't want to be healed ever again.
The temptation is there.
So, temptation, sensation. Just get up and get ready.
Man.
By the way, have you noticed anything missing yet? I think you should.
What are you talking about missing? I got my cloak, it's right there. I got my armor, right there, and I got the... Wait a minute. You see him scrambling, looking under the bed. He's like... All right. How many people do I have to kill today? And he just grabs Alistair by the collar. He's like, all right, you little... White Knight Shitlord, where is it?
I'm sorry, good sir, but I have no idea where your scythe is. I do not have it.
You see, he lifts Alistair off of his feet.
Make a force check.
Excuse me?
I'm telling you. No, you're not. You're just taking it. Thanatos is just seeing if he has the strength to lift you. Yes. He's like a pillow to you. You just lift him up, armor and all.
Alistair.
I'm telling the truth, mate. I don't have it.
He brings him close. He brings him close.
So how about you think about it? Who would you think would have it? Come on. Here's what brain cells you have left.
Is it? He brings him close, stares into his eyes for a second. It's like,
and I just got a casual look on my face.
Okay. then tosses him out into the hallway.
Oof. Alistair, you land on your ass in the hallway.
Yep.
Stomping his way around Alistair and down the hallway.
The rest of you, you hear the sound of a Tyrannosaurus Rex approaching.
And as he walks in, there is me sitting there with his with the scythe.
Oh yeah.
Knee.
Oh, Thanatos. Good morning. Do you like my new weapon? Thought I'd give it a try.
Isn't that a little big for you?
Yeah, but it was just lying there, completely unattended by its oh-so-responsible owner.
In a second, Thanatos is in front of her. Knee.
Yes?
I believe that's mine.
It appears I was able to make off with it after all, Thanatos. I win, flicks him on the nose, and then gives the scythe back.
Taking it and securing it to his back.
By the way, Caius is also in there just as much as he's in the cloak, and he wasn't so happy. Sort of kidnapped him.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I could feel it.
Yeah, you hear Kaia sort of talking in your head a second later. Hades, she isn't wrong. I created that scythe myself. It is essentially an extension of me, although the vast majority of me remains in here.
Huh. So here's a question. If I were to throw it, can I just call it back with my hand?
Alas, no. It does not work like that.
It's not Mione, or whatever the axe was called that Kratos uses.
There is a very short range on that. It pretty much has to be within arm's reach anyway for that to work.
Okay.
You can make it intangible if you want, make it dematerialize, and then call it when you need it. But if you throw it far away, you're going to have to retrieve it by hand.
Fine. Leaning down and putting the hand on Nia's shoulder, getting right in her face.
Mm-hmm. She's not intimidated in the slightest.
If you ever pull that again, you will never see your precious bolt storm.
Promises, promises, ruffles his hair.
Let it go, Thanatos.
We have one. Maybe make a threat when he's not in the middle of a Phil Central. Gestures with the house.
And you sort of look at me, you have Salika and Sklala and Rania, and Farron is just walking in with like a donut in his hand. He's like, what am I miss?
Seeing as he is outnumbered, he is going to resort to just giving her a slight bonk on the head. Bad.
Well, you may have won the Battle of the Drinking Contest, but I think I won the war.
Oh, yeah. Well, Thanatos did win, didn't he?
That's Rania talking.
Mm-hmm. Yes! So, as I recall, Rania, our deal was if I won, you have to tell Nee's most embarrassing story, other than the tower incident.
Yeah. Yeah, I do. So, get over here.
And she sort of gestures for you to approach.
Approaching.
All right. You're getting close, and she keeps gesturing for you to get closer. Until
as you're going, you notice Nee seems eerily unworried.
Yeah. Until you get in close, and Rania just sort of leans in, like, starts whispering in your ear and says,
the most embarrassing thing about Nee is that she ever had such little faith in me that she actually thought I would tell you a story like that.
And then she leans back, smirks, pats you on the cheek, and saunters off into another room.
It's official. I hate elves.
What's wrong, Drench Knight? All washed up?
Didn't I already throw you across the room
Eh, it was just a mere tap. Now get yourself dried off.
Theron chuckles a bit and finishes off his donut.
Hold on. Seeing Alistair saying that, Thanatos turns around. You see dark red energy in his hand. You want me to try this time?
All right. Simmer down, boys.
Theron.
Stop blowing up my family home. Well, I'd feed you to my mother there, to Mum.
Yeah.
So.
And
you don't want that.
And Salika just kind of works her jaw, but like,
been a while since I made that kind of cookie.
Wait, what?
Oh, nothing. Nothing. Don't you worry your young head about it. Just behave. Okay?
So, sit down, have breakfast, and I need to talk with everyone.
Oh, great.
I assume this has something to do with... this is Farron speaking. I assume this has something to do with what you and Panara found last night?
Yes, very much so.
All right. He sort of jerks his head back. All right, dining room, that's where the biggest table is. Let's go. And he heads back that way.
And you...
Wait, is Panara around?
Yeah, she's here. Yeah. She's just keeping quiet.
So, Panara, did you hear any interesting sounds in these house last night?
She looks down at you, stares at you. She just looks at you for a second and just sort of shrugs her shoulders.
I was focusing on other things.
And then walks by.
Knee backs out of the room, still glaring at Thanatos.
Mika just sort of flicks you on the nose with her tail as she passes.
Clearly you need to learn some more manners, sir.
And clearly you need to zip thy lip.
Look who's talking.
Thanatos, what did we say about control?
One, you...
God, I hate all of you. I need to blow something up after this.
All right, so you make your way. So you all make your way into the dining room, and after a short and fulfilling breakfast, we'll say Rocket, you come down a little while later. We'll say Skalala went and got you. You're still feeling a little murky in the head, but we'll say a quick application of Poisona from Alistair settles that.
Okay.
So you're all sort of gathered around the dining table, and food is wrapped up. Nee, take the lead.
Right, so is everyone seated? Because this is, might be a whole thing.
Ready when you are.
Well, we talked with Emma last night. It was a much more civil thing. I even made a table to sit at. Turns out being inside your own dream can be weird. Point being, for the next 2 days, Emma's going to be taking control.
Oh. Well, that's quite the deal you made.
I know. And it starts today.
Today?
Pretty much when this conversation ends, yes.
I'm not so sure about this, but if it's the best course of action, go right ahead then, I would say.
And what happens when she decides she doesn't want to give it back?
As far as her intentions go, we'll share a body. We have the same brain. We can see inside of each other.
To a limited extent, I should clarify. To a limited extent. You can't read each other's thoughts. You can only sense the surface level emotions.
Yeah, no deceit, just...
Does seem logical.
At the moment, she has no intention of going back on our deal. And even if something were to go wrong, no matter what that something may be, complications with the transfer, whatever,
going to be keeping an eye on things. And you guys are here. So...
Yes.
So...
She has never known what it's like to live, and... has been... This might give her a chance to kind of reconcile those feelings and move us forward.
So just so we're clear, if she tries to go back on the thing, can I punch her in the face?
No. You'd be punching me as
that,
well.
But...
I mean, technically I'd be punching her.
If something goes wrong, do what you feel you need to. I won't be there to stop you. I don't think it's going to come to that, and I'd rather you give her a chance to just kind of... days.
And there are no repercussions to this.
Panora sort of speaks up at this point.
This isn't exactly...
This is our first and probably our best chance at finding a way to get these two to live in harmony. We need to find common ground with Emma, and right now the best way to do that is to give her some time at the wheel. After that, she'll be in a better position to speak with clarity, and so will we.
She has a chance to be herself and find out who she even is. She's just going to be sitting inside my head, stewing in her own resentment. Not much can be done with that. Deal!
Farron.
2 days, you guys are going to be on your own. I don't...
Well, rest assured, and make sure that nothing happens to her.
Farron sort of... Farron leans forward...
It was your original body.
Farron leans forward at this point, and... I'm not sure I like this plan, but I can't say I really see another option, at least... not a safe one. Are you sure about this?
She... That's not 100%, but it's... the other option I've run through my head. He has expressed the desire to meet you, Dad.
Really?
Yeah, that was, like, the one time she... was displaying anything other than annoyance or anger. She kind of went a bit quiet with that. So, once this is over, that's how this is going to start, and after that, she's got 2 days to do with as she wills.
I'll be keeping a close eye on things, probably from a distance,
Panora points out.
To give her space, but make sure she doesn't pull anything.
Before we start, do you still have some spare clothes? I can borrow something maybe greenish? Because she doesn't really want to be wearing Tugs or armor, this.
Salika nods.
I can grab some here in a bit.
Thanks. So, in the meantime, guys turns towards the rest of the party. Do what you think is best for the time being, though could you replenish our supplies while I'm gone? We are low on Phoenix Downs, potions, that kind of thing.
You can count on it. I have made a list of what we need.
And we do have some stuff we need to sell, too. We still have that It Lion Pearl, don't we?
Yep, we right. do.
So I have it. I'll pass it to you, Mika, before I go.
Alright.
She takes it. I do not remember how much money it is worth. I'll need to go check that.
Well, best advice, get whatever else you need to say done. And we shall wait and greet Emma, I guess.
Go easy on her. She's been through a lot. She puts her hand on Mika's shoulder. 2 days, I will be coming back. So don't worry about me.
Alright.
Well then, if there's nothing else, Mom, Dad, if you want to come with me and get me some gear, and I can give you some stuff for safekeeping.
Yeah, of course. And they both sort of stand up, ready to take you wherever it is you're wanting to go.
She stands up, starts to follow them, but before she goes, kind of looks back at the rest of you. I'll see you guys later. Yeah?
Right.
Yeah. Be safe, Nee.
Take care of yourself, Squirt.
That's Rania.
She gives them a small smile and nod for following parents out.
Alright. So you follow them out, and you make your way to, let's say, a changing room. And some clothes are brought out, and it takes a little bit. You eventually pick out a few that you don't really have much familiarity with yourself that are in the color green. And what are you passing to your parents for safekeeping?
Well, Boltstorm and Storm, for one thing. I'll let her keep Love Letter just so she has something to defend herself with if she gets into trouble.
Alright.
And obviously all my armor and the wedding ring.
Alright.
Oh, and these dress as well. Just, you know, personal items and stuff.
Give me a second. So your armor, your dress, a Bolt, Storm, and Storm.
Yeah, and the wedding ring.
Alright. There we go. Okay, I went ahead and I wrote that down as a list. It's in the handouts tab. We can check that whenever we want in case something goes wrong. All right, so soon enough, you've got all that stuff handed over.
Yeah. All right, I appreciate this. Sorry, this is all very sudden. Everything sudden. I've dropped on you the last couple of days.
Farron and Salica sort of, you know, they mutually shake their heads.
It's fine. You're our daughter, aren't you?
Yeah. Always will be. Don't forget that.
You're the one who shouldn't ever forget. How could we? We're the ones who decided we wanted you.
Now you get to meet the other side of me.
Salica turns to Farron.
Does that mean that Emma is also technically our adopted daughter?
Let's take this one step at a time, Salica.
Now, there is a reason she wants to meet you, he quietly points out.
Yeah. Fair enough. Alright.
She kind of hugs, brings them both into a hug.
Yep. And it's returned.
I'll see you guys in 2 days. Okay?
Yeah.
Go downstairs with the others. Emma will be coming down in a few minutes.
Alright. And they head out and close the door behind them.
Right then. Kyle looks at the clothing. Will this do for a starting point? Kind of speaks out loud.
You don't sense any objection.
Well, she changes into the new stuff.
Yeah. Yep. So you get changed. It feels a little awkward on you because you're not used to it, but soon enough it's situated and adjusted to be comfortable.
Okay. Right. I'm all yours, Emma.
Alright, so...
Do it.
You close your eyes, and for a moment you sort of concentrate on that empty, blackened space where you've met Emma all the previous times, and after a moment you open your eyes, and you're no longer standing in the changing room in your family estate. You're standing in that empty space with that lone stump with the large... eye-shaped window up in front of you. It's dark at first, and it's gone from green to blue. You step forward a little bit, and as you do, you see it sort of opening up like a view from the inside of eyelids. And you are now watching as Emma moves around in the body that's largely been under your control.
How do you feel? She speaks out of the void.
A few seconds pass before Emma replies.
Strange. But I'll make do.
A little different when you're not pumped full of adrenaline.
You know, she goes to take a couple steps, and you can tell she's not used to having a body, per se, because her steps are kind of stiff and awkward and clumsy. And she, like, wobbles a bit on her feet, and it takes her a couple minutes, but eventually she finds her balance.
Well, these 2 days are yours. Nee kind of looks at the stump, and knowing what we did before, she kind of just creates a much more comfortable chair next to it.
Alright. Alright, so it just sort of materializes in. And you take
Save
a seat.
Is yours.
And you take a seat and watch. So for the rest of you, you're sort of waiting downstairs in that front living room. Salika and Farron come in after a few minutes of being away. Emma should be done in a few minutes, and he said. Does anyone have anything to say?
Well, is everyone else okay with this still?
Not really, but it's the best thing we've got so far.
Definitely going to be a bit strange getting used to this for 2 days, but
Panora,
just try to make it the best for her.
Panora pipes up.
Yeah,
Panora pipes up. I would not be surprised if Emma chooses to deliberately distance herself from all of us during this window. We're all associated with Neathil, and if there's one thing I've been able to figure out from my brief interactions with Emma, she wants nothing to do with who Nee is. She wants to find herself. The only exception to that rule that I can think of is... She nods at Salika and Farron.
You two.
Would make sense. Technically, they are her parents more.
Would have been.
Well, so she does need some space.
Well, if she wants us to be,
Salika saying as she sort of shifts on her feet,
then I wouldn't say no. She's been there all along. We just didn't know it.
But just think of all those birthdays that you have to plan for now.
Right?
Ronnie just sort of face plants.
Can we not go through all this again, please? Like, I get where you guys are coming from. Really. I do. But I'm not so sure it's the best thing right now. There's too much going on, and let's not forget, both of their lives are at stake. There's no guarantee they'll both make it out of this. And I hate to say it, but if we can't guarantee both their survivals, I'm prioritizing Nee over Emma. Nee's my sister. Emma tried to stab me. I get she's hurting, but...
She leans up against the wall.
Well, yeah.
Technically, I think it's more of trying to stab Panora than you, but...
You know what I mean.
I threw her off a table.
Yeah. There's a few minutes pass before eventually... You hear footsteps descending the nearby stairs. And you turn to look and you see... At first your instincts are like, oh, there's Nee. She's coming down. But then you see the eyes and the unusual outfit. It's very much of a more green persuasion. Has a sort of a sort of darker green, sort of almost silky sort of shoulder cape thing, almost. Sort of this white undershirt underneath it and a sort of more normal green long sleeve shirt over top of it that sort of opened up a little. That's sort of flows, has a sort of like a front thing. I don't know what you would call it, but it sort of hangs down in front of the legs, like a section of a skirt almost. And just darker pants and regular shoes as she comes down. I can probably do up a drawing of it at some point. And she sort of looks around as she comes down, and eventually her eyes settle on Farron and Salika, who've taken a center stage in the room. Farron sort of lifts a hand. Hello. I don't think we've met yet, have we?
No, we haven't.
She steps down the rest of the way and eventually sort of comes face to face with them. Is there anything any of the rest of you want to say?
Hi, Emmy.
Emma looks over at you as you say that and just stares at you for a second before refocusing on Farron and Salika. Seems like she's not sure how to respond to that.
Well, she cleans up a little better than he does.
I think this is a personal matter that we must leave them to sort out. So I think we should exit the room. Be the best course of action.
Right, so to the rest of you, Emma starts talking to Farron and Salika in hushed voices. It's, you know, kind of clearly trying to sort of keep it between amongst themselves. Nee, you're able to pick up on the entirety of the conversation because you're observing it from Emma's perspective. And it's very low-toned, as I mentioned.
What's the gist?
The gist is sort of awkward greetings and introductions. And then Salika and Farron, coming as no surprise to you whatsoever, or to Emma, sort of express, you know, that they apologize for what's happened to her and express that they hope they can find a way through this. And as it's sort of going back and forth, eventually Salika's smile sort of grows a bit. And
I assume you heard what we said earlier at the table? I did. About me technically being your adopted child too, right?
You were there from the start. I wouldn't want to force that on you. I know how much you want to not be Nee, but if we can ever find a way to get you your own body, then, well,
we'd be happy to have you too. We took in Nee. You were part of the package. It's our responsibility to accommodate that.
After a few moments, Emma gives a slow nod.
Right. Well, I'll definitely keep that in mind. But right now, I just need time to myself. I need to know who I really am.
Understandable. You're welcome here if you ever decide to come back, though.
It would also be nice to have a bed to sleep in. Nee points out from inside her head.
Emma sort of smirks.
Well, we do need a bed to sleep in, don't we?
Sort of mirroring what you said to the others outside. A couple seconds pass before she looks to the rest of the party, who are all still sort of looking on.
I thought we exited the room, but what?
Not, Alistair suggested that, but no one committed to it. And Rocket loudly declared, "Hi, Emmy!" So, eventually, Emma just sort of looks between the rest of you before looking down and...
Hmm. I'd appreciate it if none of you followed me. I'm willing to let Panara follow me, but not the rest of you. Leave me to myself.
Then she looks over at Panara.
And speaking of Panara, I hope you keep to your word and let me have my space. If you interrupt me, I will punch you. Or understood? Perfectly. Good.
Then Emma just turns and starts heading for the exit.
Before you go, we will give you your space, but if you ever do need help with anything, we'd be hanging around somewhere.
And as Emma nods at that, and then Ronia pipes up.
Yeah, and one more thing. Don't hurt my sister. I get what you're going through. Just don't hurt Neathil.
Keep your end of the deal, and we'll keep ours.
Me internally is both, what's the word I'm looking for? I'm flattered. I completely forgotten the word I was going to use. Not flattered, but...
Touched?
Touched, that's what I was looking for. Thank you.
Right.
These were simultaneously touched and a little irritated that they had to directly confront over that.
Emma sort of shrugs her shoulders.
I don't think I could hurt her even if I wanted to. It would mean hurting the body, and we both depend on it. So you don't have to worry about that.
And with that, Emma steps through the door. Closes it behind her. And from Nee's perspective, you watch as Emma just stands there at the front door for a minute and takes a few deep breaths. And then just starts wandering. And while she's doing that, she'll be gone for quite a while. The rest of you, what are you doing?
Well, that was awkward.
It was, but, well, what can we do? Just gonna give him
okay?
Mika nods.
Yeah, I'll be fine. It's me I'm worried about. But I'm sure she knows what she's doing.
Yeah. Don't worry. She's...
Meanwhile, inside Nee's head, I have no idea what I'm doing.
Yeah, she's too stubborn to let somebody else stay in control for long.
Panora nods at that.
Perhaps. But I have my own tasks to see to. I should get to it.
And she turns and starts heading for the door. She then pauses for a moment and glances back over to Salika and Farron.
On that note, before I depart, what all did Nee give you?
Just her armor, an old dress, most of her weapons... Farron's eyes sort of dart over at Meek, and she's like,
What?
Panara's like, that's what I need. And just sort of wanders over, and the rest of you watch as he subtly takes something but hides it from view. And Mika is trying to get a view, and was like, And Taka's like,
what do you need it for? Just some examinations. Just so I have a better idea of what I'm working with.
And she smiles and turns to Mika, who's like marching right up to her.
Okay, what the hell is going on? How many people are in on this? What is it?
not for you to know. Panara just lifts her hands placatingly. Look, it's not my idea. If you want to blame someone, take it up with... She turns and points at Rania. Accuse her.
What? What? Why me? Why me? Why me?
Because at this point I figured out if Mika confronts me, she will crack.
Rania fumes for a second.
Fine, you've got a point.
Sucks being the big sister, doesn't it?
Oh, you have no idea. Little siblings are so idiotic sometimes.
Skull crosses her arms.
Excuse me? What, it's true? It's not! Yeah, you see, you're the one doing the is not is too thing right now, so it kind of is.
Well, she's not wrong.
And then Rania sort of glances over at Thanatos.
You know, you kind of seem like the little brother of the group, don't you?
Little brother? I'm pretty sure I'm older than all of these people.
I mean, maybe physically, but mentally?
She shrugs.
That's up for debate.
I'll go shoot an arrow.
I will. I will go shoot arrows. I still have to go do my job today.
So then she turns to Skalala.
What about you? I think I'm probably going to hang around here for the time being. Fair enough. Okay.
And with that, Rania heads out. And so does Panara. Leaving Mika just sort of standing there, frustratedly fuming like,
get back here! You haven't told me anything!
And then rushes off after them.
Oh, thank God. I can't... If I had both of you throwing random stuff in my head, I just don't tell them what would happen.
I don't know. I think she hit the nail on the coffin with you.
Oh, piss off. Freaking white knight, white mage, stick paladin.
Oh, I'm so hurt my feelings feel crushed.
I love the dysfunction of this whole damn party. Anyway,
and
so, what do you... Yes, you do. So, what are you guys doing?
Well, the one with most of the cash and the trade-in just ran off, so...
I mean,
she didn't have that. I think we still have that. I would have thought.
The party kill is communal, but Mika does have the antlion eye. Or pearl.
All right, let's go get...
We focus on getting resources.
Let's go rescue Rania so we can get the pearl. Or we could just take the pearl and let Rania deal with the cat.
Mika has the pearl, and she went running off.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So we have to go save her. Right. Let's get the pearl.
Okay.
Well, let's just get resources.
Yeah, for purposes, for brevity's sake, we'll say that you're able to catch up to Mika easily enough. She lost track of Rania, who expertly slid into the shadows and slinked away.
Yeah, I figured you'd be an expert at tracking down elves at this point.
I've only ever had to track the one.
And this one was raised the same way, so I figured maybe you loosen your touch a little bit.
Thanatos?
Yes.
She casts stop on you.
That's gonna be a thing now with him. Yep. I love it.
Oh, it's not sleep.
Yeah. Alright. So she casts...
It's been a thing since campaign start.
Yep, so she casts stop on you and just kinda hooks up with everyone else as you all head out. Okay, so what are you all doing?
Well, we
probably need some resources, so any place like that would be great.
We need to sell stuff.
Alright, selling the antlion pearl. Okay.
Did we get anything from the basilisk?
The highest bidder.
Did we get anything from the basilisk or the corals?
I think you just got gil and maybe a couple of gold needles, but that was it.
Yeah.
I'd be more interested to know if anyone got anything from the golems back in Kinatoa. I think I had them drop something, but I don't remember.
I think it was just gil.
It was gil.
Okay.
Yeah, for sure. So how much gil do we have right now?
Well, right now, before selling the antlion pearl, you have 7,037. Upon selling the Antlion Pearl, if you will give me a second.
To remember, sure. To look up exactly how much that is.
I know how much it is now. I'm pulling up my calculator because it's a big number. That number jumps from 7,000 to 12,000. Because the Antlion Pearl was worth 5,000 gil.
Holy shit.
I just looked up stuff.
Guys, we could make a killing getting these from the Badlands.
All right. So, you now have 12,000 gil total. What are you buying with that? Does everyone have the rule book open and know what they're getting?
Well, first, you focus on supplies.
I have the rule book open. Any idea what letter, page the items are on?
They'll be in the equipment chapter, which begins on page 118. Universal equipment list would be where samples are. Which is page 125, so you can get like the prices for like different tiers of weapons and armor and shields and whatnot.
We can't get any new tier stuff yet, so
not yet, no. Sample consumables, so like usable items and whatnot, would show up on page 142. But you could also pick up other things, there are some sample foods you could get.
That's what I was going to ask about. What's the max tier we can have at level 7?
At level 7? If you really wanted to double down and shell out a fuck ton of money, you could theoretically get something from tier 4, but it'd be expensive.
I think about that.
So right now you're pretty much stuck at tier 3.
Yeah, we're not getting any tier 4 stuff until we can actually
use it. I'm not after anything like that. I mean, I know my armor's 3. My staff is still 2, which I think is okay at the moment. It's just mostly shooting spells.
Okay,
then again, I wonder what kind of advancements I would get with 3.
Largely just a higher damage multiplier.
I mean, but again, that's just with his regular attack, which he doesn't do all that much.
Right.
Nah, I only have stack 2.
Correct. So, far as I can tell right now, the most important thing we should probably spend gil on is potions and ethers as such.
Could also spend money on accessories as a heads up. The accessory list is on page 139.
That'll be something else we may be able to look at. First things first. Let's go through a list of everybody's potions and stuff. I have one potion, and that's one regular potion. That's about it. Okay.
Yeah. Mika has 2 antidotes, 2 eye drops, 3 vials of holy water, 2 golden needles, a phoenix down, and a regular potion.
Okay, so Mika still has the phoenix down, and she has a regular potion. Mm-hmm. Okay, Alessia, what do you have?
Well, only 2 ethers, a regular potion, and a phoenix down, and no longer the 2 books that have been done. So I would like probably 2 high potions and 2 high ethers, to be honest.
Okay, so 2 high potions are 200 gil each, and I imagine... I don't see ethers on here, so I imagine...
They're right below the potions on the sample consumables, page 142.
Yeah, and it's the high ethers I'm after, because I've got 2 ethers.
Okay, here we go. So, yeah, high potion is 200 each, and high ethers is 200 each. So, mm-hmm. So say
800 altogether for me.
So 800 of that would... could go to Alistair for 2 high potions and 2 high ethers.
Okay.
What does Rocket have?
Let's see. Holy water, branch shoes, a phoenix down, phoenix headdress, Lyle's chocobo armor, that book, some geishal greens, choco claws, and comparison lightning, and a cloak.
Hmm.
Okay, so Okay, that was actually that was a lot more than I was expecting. It's just as far as potions go, what did you have?
Holy water.
So no high potions or regular potions?
Nope.
Okay. So how about, since Rocket doesn't use magic, let's say 3 high potions to Rocket? Does that sound fair?
That sounds good.
Does that sound fair to you, Lumina?
Yeah.
Okay. So
that's 600 gil for 3 high potions to Rocket. Let's just say, so everybody has a Phoenix down other than me.
Yeah. The pricey one.
Actually, we don't...
Just to remember, out of character, I don't have one.
Okay, so Nia doesn't have one either. Okay, so... Phoenix Downs are 600 each. So let's buy 2 Phoenix Downs, 1 for me and 1 for Nia. And we'll give it to her at a later date.
Okay.
So... that is now a thing. Let's also... get me 2 high potions and 2 high ethers. That's another 800 gil there. All right, how are we looking now?
Hovering at around 8,600 gil with all those purchases.
Nice.
That's still pretty decent.
Let's see. I'm going to have Mika purchase 2 high potions and 2 high ethers as well.
Okay, so that's another 800.
And let me see here.
And we can also do accessories. Let's see if.
If you can't find one of the sample accessories list you like, you could customize one, but that would be time consuming because you'd have to find your desired, properties and whatnot.
Yeah.
Mm.
We can all look through accessories, and if you see one, preferably the ones that range from 250 to 600. So we don't, because I don't think we really want to blow 2,000 or 7,500.
Oh, interesting. Mika doesn't actually have any accessories right now.
Okay. Well, then...
yeah, for us not.
Then the Mika can do as she likes.
Yep, I will have her pick up a tier 2 accessory that gives her a +2 to mine.
The magician shoes?
No. I'll have this be a pearl necklace. I'll name it.
Okay, interesting. Okay,
Let's see here. And as that is a tier 2 accessory, that will cost 600 gil itself. But it also means her mind score has now been bumped up to 14, so long as she has it equipped.
Hmm.
No ways to burn myself like that.
I still remember. I still have the chocobo whistle, but can you have more than one accessory?
You can have more than one accessory, but you can only have one equipped.
Okay. I remember getting that chocobo whistle just for shits and giggles, and we've still never used it.
We've had plans to use it in the emergency, but usually avoided it. We've managed to avoid the emergency.
Yeah.
I'm going to use it to alert you guys if I got caught. Oh no, it wasn't.
Yeah. Alright, anything else, you guys?
I'm just looking through some of the sample accessories. See if anything strikes my fancy.
That's what I'm looking at.
I could just go with the extra power attribute.
I am actually going to have Mika grab one more accessory, but it's not going to be for her.
Okay.
Yeah. Just so that you know where that next 600 gil went.
Okay.
Hmm.
Yeah. Give me a second to...
I mean, accessory-wise... I don't know, maybe like a cape for LSI or something.
Eh. I think I'm just gonna go with the... I'll just go with the sample accessory there, the muscle belt, which gives me +2 to power. So that is another 600.
All right. So gil numbers are now hovering at around 6,000.
Okay. So Thantos's power has jumped up to 15.
Sweet.
Nice.
All right. Yeah, I still have the chocobos. Okie dokies. Other than that, I think we've spent enough money so far.
Is everyone satisfied with their purchases?
I mean... The only thing I could think of is like probably a cape for Alessia, but then again.
Well, I can't think right now.
Is it what?
What kind of property would you like? Extra mind, or.
I have got a lot. Hmm.
You could customize it too if you went to the universal property list. You would just have to be mindful that it would take some time.
Yeah. I probably would like to take more time of it and figure it out.
Right.
Yeah, you can talk to... I say, if you come up with something that you want, you can talk to Tone after the session is over and customize it if you wish.
Yeah, because my stat-wise are, at the moment, 8 power, 8 raz, 8 dex, and 13 mind. So, I'm just trying to think of the best way to, you know... If I wanted something on it to increase the property.
I say property increases are always... Yeah. Stat increases are always good.
Yeah.
And stuff like that is always good. But again, if you think of something, you can talk to Tone after the session is over and customize it.
Indeed, yeah.
So, yeah. If everybody is fine with that, I think that's... good for our shopping spree.
Oh, it would be nice to have a Zephyr cape.
Zephyr cape?
What's the Zephyr cape?
It adds to your buoyance.
It does add to the buoyance. Would you like Rocket to have a cape?
I mean, Rocket's avoidance is already ludicrous, isn't it? If anything, Thanatos could use that.
In fairness, we did kind of nerf Rocket's avoidance after a good long while because we had
it was 12 at first, wrong. Wasn't it?
Mm. I mean, it was 12 like way back when we were level 3.
Right.
I do miss that. That was the fun days.
What is Rocket's avoidance, Numina?
9.
It's currently sitting at 9.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, if you want to buy a Zephyr Cape and bump that up a little bit, go for it.
I mean, that would still cause you... you'll have to unequip whatever accessory you currently have, which I believe is still the thing that gives you fire immunity.
Okay, which one is that?
I believe it's the Phoenix accessory. The Phoenix barding.
Yeah, the Phoenix dress that we got you.
I mean, I have got one question.
Yes?
What?
Is there no way to increase accuracy at all, or does accuracy stay as it is?
I'm pretty sure there's a property for that.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure there's a property for
yeah,
that.
Yeah, 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 yeah. There's a property. Accurate. It can be applied to tier 2 or tier 5 accessories. Wearing this relic confers a +1 bonus to the user's ACC score, +1 bonus to their AVD score, or a +2 bonus on all opposed rolls. A tier 5 or better version of this property doubles these values. This property may be added multiple times, but a different bonus must be chosen each time.
That would be nice for me, because mine's at 4 accuracy. I mean, avoidance is all right with me, it's 7. It's just accuracy.
To be perfectly honest, Darkness, with your build being more spell-based and taking damage, you don't usually do melee attacks all that much anyway.
Yeah, so you wouldn't really need accuracy.
True. So yeah, accuracy I don't think is a big deal for you. Again, no. if I were you, I would maybe put it into increasing your mind, considering most of your spells rely on mind.
What accessory do you currently have equipped, Alistair?
Let's see.
I think you still have the frost cloak from when you were ascending Anemo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The frost cloak. Yeah, it's not written down, but I do remember that cloak.
So yeah, we all have that.
Yeah.
We just never.
Which is why I've been thinking on a new cloak that's much better.
Well, if you want to get something that increases your mind so that you deal more damage and heal more HP, you can totally do that.
That would be a good idea. I like that.
Okay.
So, yeah, the mind deal.
Yep.
Sample says magician shoes, but if you want to, like, make a new cape or a wristband or a ring or whatever that you want to put on and go for.
Yeah.
You can customize that if you wish, but
your cosmetics can be whatever you want, really. The stats are not tied to your cosmetics.
Okay, so
it would probably be a white and blue cape, to be honest.
Right. Okay, so back to Rocket, who wanted the extra avoidance. Did you still want that, Lumina?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so we can give her the Zephyr cape or whatever kind of accessory she wants it to be.
All right, so combining the plus the avoidance thing combined with the mind boost for Alistair, we're hovering now at about 4,800 gil.
All right, everybody's got new accessories. We've got items. Is everybody satisfied?
Yep.
All right.
So we blew through quite a bit of gil, but I think that'll work.
All righty.
I just need to know how much mind I get extra.
2.
Plus 2. Put keep your current value as is, and then just in parentheses next to it, add in the increased value.
I just put plus 2 next to the 13.
That'll work.
Yeah, that's all right. Yeah.
What's cool about this is I get the accessory and my armor also increases my power, so I have plus 4 power. Yay, me.
I've even been looking back at all my spells, and yeah, mind's the best course of action. The only thing that doesn't use mind is wind.
Wind uses mind, isn't it?
Well, it uses the MP, but I mean,
I'm pretty sure white magic uses mind, doesn't it, Tom?
Largely, yeah. The damage attacks will still rely on power, but unless you're a red mage like Mika and pick up the Kara's magic ability, in which case she can use whichever's higher, power or mind.
I'm curious. Aurora, I think is what he said. Yeah, Aurora uses power, and I think Dia also uses power.
Yeah. Anyway, so, any other purchasing we want to do, or is that good?
I think that's good.
Okay.
That's fine.
So we'll say you all spend the day doing that, picking up new things.
Yes.
And while they're doing that, Nii, you are watching Emma go through her day, and for several hours after she leaves the Ithil household, she's just walking around, just wandering aimlessly, essentially, just looking at things. She's not really saying anything, she's not interacting with anyone, she's just walking. Meanders all throughout the district you were in and eventually winds up meandering out into the larger district off to the eastern side of the city, the more common regions, and just wanders. Is there anything in particular you're doing or saying, or are you just leaving her to her devices?
For now, just leaving her to it. I'm not going to interrupt. Just kind of figure things out.
All right.
Hype up ifs. I feel I need to, but right now, don't worry, because she's just kind of exploring.
Fair enough. All right. And like I said, she is at this for several hours, and you can tell that her legs are starting to burn and she's starting to get tired, but she's just stubbornly pushing on.
At that point, Neil,
come up pipe up, like, you know, you could find somewhere to sit down for a little while. You have a body now. You need to look after it.
Hmm. Eventually, Emma just sort of finds an elevated spot in the city. We'll say up here in the northern end of this eastern district. It sort of slopes up a bit. You know, sort of rises up. Those individual sort of rings are sort of different tiers. It sort of steps up higher into the terrain. She finds a spot on the highest one, and there's sort of like an overlook looking over the rest of the forested city, and there's a little stone bench nearby, and she just gets comfortable on that.
It's strange. I know my way all around this place. Even though I only really became consciously aware of it a few weeks back.
And yet I guess it's new for you.
It is and it isn't. I've watched from your eyes as you've walked around this place for so much of your life. Never actually had any say in where to go myself, though.
Well, there's a whole city, various things to do, and beyond it, that's why I let you have the knife.
I don't plan on wandering past the city gates. Much as I want to, I'm not stupid enough to go out there alone when things are as tense as they are.
There is a dragon out there still.
And amber demons.
Well, intent on trying to destroy him and the world.
Yeah. I'm not going to lie to you. If it weren't for that situation, I would not be as patient with you as I've been.
If it wasn't for that situation, we could have put all of our time and resources from here on into figuring this out, but as much as I want to, I'm not sure the God of Darkness is going to sit idly.
He definitely isn't. Demon's presence here is evidence enough of that.
If he gets his way, neither of us will have a world to live in.
I kind of feel sorry for him.
I get you. He lost his world. It was so bitter that he's willing to do something horrible.
Kind of like how I lost a body, my chance at my life.
There is a big difference between you and him.
Well, yeah, I'm not a god.
For one thing, you listen to reason. He's many millennia beyond that.
Maybe. Well, all right, mess you found yourself in, isn't it?
No. One must wonder how things would have done if I had just done what the universe wanted and died all those years ago.
Well, then I would be Neothil, wouldn't I? I would have lived the life you have.
I suppose, but by that very token, you never would have met Thanatos, Mika. It was my drive to find out about myself that led to that. And then who knows what would have happened in Marasu.
They would have met. They would have met each other, so.
But remove even just one of us from the equation, whether it's me, Rocket, Thanatos. That's a domino.
I suppose it is.
But things went how they went. So here we are.
She spends a little while just sitting there in silence. Before eventually she stands up, dusts herself off, and keeps going.
You know, we probably look rather silly sitting there talking to ourselves.
I honestly don't care. If they have a problem with it, they can fight me. Or you. You have more experience on that front.
Just give the word.